If you have a smartphone in the Google Pixel 8 series or Pixel 9 series, then I can show you how to return the phone back to 100% stock Android firmware. This is ideal if you have previously modded your phone and now you want to relock the bootloader. So, if you have rooted your phone with a tool like Magisk or APatch, or maybe you have installed a mod like TWRP, or you have a custom ROM installed, like I have here, and you want to return the phone back to its stock Android firmware, then the Android Flash tool is going to be the easiest method. Just be aware that this will erase everything you have on your device, so be sure to back up your important data ahead of time. But before you can use this tool, you need to make sure that you have developer mode enabled so that you can then turn on USB debugging mode. With that done, you then want to connect your Pixel 8 or Pixel 9 to the PC with a USB cable, and then pull up the Android Flash Tool website. And I'll have this linked down below in the video description, as well as the pinned comment, so that it's easy for everyone to find. As of right now, Firefox does not support web USB, so you will need to use a browser like Chrome or Edge in order to use the Android Flash tool. As soon as you visit the website, you're going to be asked to grant access to ADB keys. So we're going to click on Allow Access. And if you have not allowed USB debugging access yet, on the phone you will get an Allow or Cancel prompt. So make sure that you tap on Allow from there so that our Chrome browser can access the phone. So we're going to click on this Select Device drop-down menu and then choose the Pixel 8 series or Pixel 9 series phone that you have connected. If you want, you can use the search box here to pick a branch, target, or build ID. However, it's usually easiest to scroll down here and choose either a beta version or go back to the public version, which is what I recommend. So this will take you to the latest public stable build of Android. Now you're going to choose if you have a phone from Verizon, Telus, or any other wireless carrier that you see here, or if it is factory unlocked, meaning you got it from the Google Play Store. So we're going to click on default. And then we're going to click on this edit icon, as this will give us access to these options. You want to make sure that the wipe device option is selected, and you can choose if you want to lock the bootloader here or not. I do not want to relock the bootloader right now, so I'm going to uncheck that option. And we want to make sure that the force flash all partitions option is selected, since we want to completely wipe the phone. Now with all of this set up, when you're ready, we're going to click on Install Build. This gives us a summary of the phone we're flashing, the version of Android we're flashing, and some warnings to not unplug the device, don't interact with the device unless instructed to do so by this page, and another reminder that this is going to factory data reset all of the data on our device. So back up any personal data, such as photos, videos, and anything else. When you're ready to proceed, click on Confirm, and then I accept. Now, you can see here that some additional action is required. So we're going to always allow from this computer on our phone, and then again, click on Allow on our device. You may not see that prompt if you have that option already selected, but it's something to be aware of. Now from here, we just want to let the Android Flash tool do all the work for us. So it's going to download that latest public build of Android. You can see the progress meter here. And this may take a long time if you have a slow internet connection, or it may be very quick. We're just going to wait and make sure that we aren't handling the phone or touching the USB cable, because again, we want to maintain a secure connection throughout this whole process. As it starts to finish up that download, you'll see it switch to flashing a couple images. Your phone will reboot, and that means Android Flash Tool needs to wait a little bit. It will then go and flash the radio. It'll reboot the phone again. So again, we're just going to let the Android Flash Tool do all the work for us as it brings our Pixel 8 or Pixel 9 series phone back to stock Android. You'll notice that some of these files are rather large, so it's just going to be a waiting game while the website finishes wrapping up this process. Once it finishes, you'll see this green install complete message right here, and the Pixel 8 or Pixel 9 series will reboot on its own. As it boots back up, it will take a little bit longer than normal because again, it just erased everything on the phone, so it has to set some things back up. But it will bring you to the Android activation screen so that we can log back into our account. I'm going to go ahead and skip through all of this so that we can get back to Android. So, if you have modded your device with something like Magisk, a custom recovery, or a custom ROM, I would only relock the bootloader after returning the phone back to stock firmware in this way. You could also manually flash the firmware files via fastboot mode yourself, but the method I showed you here today is so much easier. However, if you would like to see the manual method, then let me know down in the comment section below. If there's enough demand for it, then I would be happy to show that process as well. If you ran into any issues following this guide, please let me know. And do not forget to like this video while also subscribing to the channel for more Android content like this.